What is the difference between PRP and ACell for hair restoration? Hi, I keep reading about PRP for hair restoration, and now I'm reading about ACell. What is the difference between the two treatments, and does anyone on this site do them in Los Angeles? I live in Calabasas, and have not found anyone who performs either. Please help. I'm 48, and this year, for some reason, my hair is disappearing. I eat well, exercise, and take vitamins. Is there a doctor in Los Angeles that can help?
Thank you for your question. You're asking, what is the difference between PRP and ACell for hair restoration treatment? Now, you submitted your question without a photo, but I certainly can help you understand how I explain our treatment and a lot of the nuance in the actual substance of your question. A little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers, a system we developed derived from use and experience of PRP and acellular matrix going on for over 7 years, helping patients from around the world and arguably amongst the first physicians to use this material. And we have developed systems based on individual clinical profiles to customize the treatment. So I want to first give you a little bit of perspective, a little bit of historic perspective. When acellular matrix was first being employed, it was being employed for hair transplant surgery. Hair transplant surgery has always been fraught with two significant challenges. One is maximizing the survivability of hair grafts. Two was improving the healing of the donor area. A serendipitous consequence, of course, like many medical discoveries, was that thinning hairs in some patients appear to get thicker. Well, what I did was, after seeing that possibility, was I started to offer the treatment as a standalone treatment for different types of hair loss. This included male pattern hair loss, female pattern hair loss, alopecia areata, scarring alopecia, such as lichen planopilaris, central centrifugal cicatricial alopecia, frontal fibrosing alopecia, alopecia totalis. Essentially, we were trying to help as many people as we could with what was in the beginning a significant impact on the treatment potential in the treatment of hair loss. What I have determined over the course of time, and this was an evolution that, especially during the early years where not very few people were really doing this and there were no clear answers as to the best way to formulate the PRP, to dose the acellular matrix, to dose it in individual injections, to get the best way to deliver the material. Essentially, we were dealing with a lot of unknowns. And to help develop predictability and consistency, we had to look at our results very critically and manage and document the responses and look at the dosing very specifically. And it took many, many years. And I like to think it's always a work in progress. At this point, we have essentially algorithms based on what I call clinical profiles. What we do to help our patients is determine the relative value of our system based on gender, age, age of onset of hair loss, rate of progression of hair loss, degree of hair loss, other previous treatments and the responsiveness, as well as the other medical variables that are important in managing hair loss. So what we're doing essentially is managing hair loss. Many, many of our more vocal colleagues were very dismissive and continue to be dismissive. Thankfully, in the dermatology literature, PRP's role in hair loss has been now well established through the publication of peer-reviewed articles. Took time, eventually they're starting to catch up. However, what is the challenge that you're facing now as a prospective patient is that doctors are embracing this now as a potential benefit to helping people with hair loss without having a clear plan. PRP can stimulate hair growth. Acellular matrix can stimulate hair growth. So what's the difference? Well, we have to think about it from the scientific point of view. Acellular matrix exists not just for hair loss. In fact, its original purpose was for wound healing and continues to be such. I use this material extensively in my other cosmetic procedures, whether it's facelifting surgery, grafts of skin grafts and other tissue grafts, for basically any kind of incision which I want to expedite healing or challenging situations where I have reconstructive procedures, I leverage the benefit of acellular matrix for its ability to stimulate adult stem cells to enhance wound healing. I find that the combination is greater than each element on its own. But the dosing and delivery methods is what challenged us continuously to optimize the results for our patients. So essentially, there is no clear understanding as to the mechanism of how these modalities help people stimulate hair growth. But in our practice, what we have developed is algorithms to help different patients with different clinical profiles. And I look at the feasibility and the practical longevity of effectiveness in every given patient's clinical profile. For example, a young male with aggressive hair loss progression and who has advanced hair loss is going to be treated very differently than a middle-aged male with slow progression, later onset, and moderate hair loss, or a female with later onset and moderate hair loss. Each patient comes with their own clinical profile. So I would say that it's very important to meet with the doctors and ask, what is the plan? Is the plan simply come to the office every month for an injection, or come to the office every 3 months for an injection with no clear sense of what is the expected outcome and what is the commitment to long-term management? I think that a lot of my colleagues are going to be getting a more of an awakening when this one size fits all, whether the distinction is to say, I have the best PRP machine, or my PRP is better than the guy next door, which is not relevant, and whether this one shotgun approach, which is basically using the same formulation of PRP and acellular matrix for every patient, is not going to yield the results that they would expect with consistency, and it's already starting to become the case. Patients are reaching out to us after they've had treatments done elsewhere for a more experienced perspective. I think that it's ultimately in your best interest to interview the doctors and see what is their level of experience and whether or not you can get some sense of predictability and what kind of role does this technology play in your overall hair loss management. I emphasize to all our patients, and 95% of patients with hair loss have androgenetic alopecia, genetic pattern loss, is that hair loss is progressive. There is no cure, but there are strategies to manage hair loss. Pharmaceutical, non-surgical as well as surgical. And the art is in maximizing the effectiveness to get the most coverage for the longest period of time in essentially managing this hard wiring in the DNA. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.